takes the power of sin and darkness. Oh, his love is mighty and so much stronger. The King of glory, the King above all kings. Oh, shakes the whole earth with holy thunder and leaves us breathless and awe and wonder. This is unfailing love, that you would take my place, that you would bear my cross. You lay down your life, that I would be set free. To order, who makes the orphan a son and daughter, the King of glory, the King of glory, who rules the nations with truth and justice, shines like the sun in all of its brilliance, the King of glory, the King above all kings. This is a grace. This is a failing love, that you would take my place, that you would bear my cross. You lay down your life that I would be set free.
Those walls are up now. this we call death and grave. They were like mountains that stood in our way, but he came and he died and he rose. Those giants are dead now. This is our God, this is who he is, he loves us. This is our God, this is what he does, he saves us. He bore the cross, beat the grave, let heaven and earth proclaim, this is our God, King Jesus. Remember that fear that took our breath away, faith so weak that we could barely pray, but he heard every word.
My mind to Calvary, where Jesus bled and died for me. I see his wounds, his hands, his feet. My Savior wore that cursed tree. Drenched in tears, they laid him down in Joseph's tomb, the entrance sealed by heavy stone. Messiah still and all
his name.
pierce the night, and I will rise among the saints, my gaze transfixed on Jesus' face.
Church, this last song is the new one that I had introduced last week that has such beautiful words. It says, how deep the Father's love for us, how vast beyond all measure that he should give his only son to make a wretch his treasure. How great the pain of searing loss. The Father turns his face away as wounds which mar the chosen one bring many sons to glory. Let's all sing this one together.
How deep the Father's love for us, how vast beyond all measure, that He should give His only Son to make a wretch His treasure. How great the pain of searing loss, the Father turns His face away, as wounds which mar the chosen one bring many sons to glory. Behold the man upon a cross, my sin upon his shoulders. Ashamed I hear my mocking voice call out among the scoffers. It was my sin that held him there until
pure lamb, without stain, without sin, who gave his life for us to be reborn, so that I can stand here in this house of prayer and I can lift up my voice and say, oh, praise the name of the Lord. And I stay here washed clean of your blood, Jesus, for we gain of your reward through the wounds that you brought onto yourself. Oh, we did not deserve such a gift from you, God. But you said, I will send them a Savior, for I see that they toiled in their days. And I thank you, God, that you sent your only Son, your most precious gift of all, for us. For I am nothing but a wretch. I am nothing but a weak creation. And I thank you, God, that you look to me. I thank you that you looked in all of my weaknesses and all of my shortcomings and you said, still I will send you my son. Still I will save you from this hell that awaits you. Oh, you're such a good God. I thank you, Lord, that your presence is here right now. And I thank you that we felt you this morning. I thank you that with you, you brought your peace that you filled every heart with, Father. And if there is someone here that has not opened their doors to you, Lord, if their heart remains stone, I ask, Lord, that you open it, Father. That you open each and every heart and that you speak to them, Lord. And that they feel that you are a God that is living. That you are a God who hears our prayers when we cry out to you. That you are a God who understands our sufferings. Oh, you're a good God to us. I thank you that your sun shines upon us today. That we feel the freedom in this country. That we are not persecuted as Christians. That we can come here united as one voice under one banner, Father, before you. And I forgive you, God, that I do not give you more of my time to you. I forgive you, Father, that I do not give you more of my effort than I should, Father. Because you deserve all the glory and all the honor and all the praise. I have nothing to bring to reciprocate what you have done for us. But I will bring you my heart, Father. I will give you my soul. I will give you my mind. And I thank you, Father, that you do not let your wrath pour out upon us. I thank you that still on this earth we find your peace, we find your comfort, and we find your goodness and your grace wherever we are, Father. You are such a good God. You are such a holy God. That is why when we are in your presence, we quake and we quiver. Because you are the God who formed the very foundations of this earth. You are the God who sprung the mountains from the ground. And you are the one who rose the kings for all the nations of all history. And through all the time, all the ages, you are the only one who still stands. I thank you, God, that 2,000 years ago, you sent your son. And I thank you, Jesus, that you renounced all the glory in heaven and you came down to be born in a manger for me, Jesus. You lived such a poor life and you taught us so many things so that we could benefit from this. And I thank you, Jesus, for your life that is a testimony thousands of years later. I ask that you bless the person that will speak from your word today, Father. I ask that you open our hearts of stone and that you help us to receive your words, Father. Transform us today so that we may leave from here changed and that we may take the good news to others. The good news that there is a Savior for this world. That there is a Savior for your hardships. There is a Savior for your sickness. That there's a Savior for your depression and your anxiety. That there's a Savior for all of us. I thank you, God. You are good and gracious. In your Jesus' name, in your name I prayed. Amen.
Before we close out this time of worship, I just want to sing the last two lines of that song I just sang.
Why should I gain from his reward? I cannot give in. But this I know with all my heart, his wounds have paid my ransom.
I know this with all my heart, his wounds have paid my ransom. Amen.
Amen.
I want to say again, welcome Hosanna Church into the house of the Lord. If we can all take just a moment to turn to our left and right and to greet each other in the name of the Lord, and we are going to move on to community time. Thank you again, worship team, and thank you again, tech team.